Hey, I'm Cameron McKenzie at CameronMCNZ on Twitter, and I want to blow you away by showing you how easy it is to create a Java servlet-based file uploader if you're using a relatively modern edition of the Servlet and JSP API, that is 3.1 or 4, something like that, or newer. If you do, I'm going to show you how to actually put together a Java servlet file uploader in only about 5 lines of code. It's incredibly easy. So kicking off this Java servlet Ajax file upload project, I need a web project. It's going to be Maven based here. I like Maven. I'm going to choose to create a Maven project, just a simple one. And for the group ID, make it com.mcnz.web. The artifact is going to be servlet Java web Ajax upload, I guess. And then the package, which is the only thing that really matters here, is going to be war, because this is a web module. Now, as soon as I fill this out, Eclipse is going to clap back at me saying, hey, you know what? This is a web module and you're supposed to have a web.xml file in it. You can see that white X right there. Some people say it's a red X. It is not a red X. It is a white X on a red background. But it says web.xml is missing. And so I can fix that. I've actually got to make a couple of changes to this POM file here. I have to add one dependency and a couple of plug-in references. So I'm gonna throw this code in here and just explain it in a moment. What I'm doing is I'm saying that in order for this to run, I need the Servlet API 4.01. And in fact, you need 3.1 or newer. The stuff I'm gonna do here won't work on 2.5. If you're using 2.5, upgrade to 3.1 or 4. For that matter, on 2.5, you'd have to use the apachecommons.io file uploader to get this to work. If you're using 3.0, most of this will work except getting the file name with the parts object. So that would be frustrating. If you're using 3.1 or newer, everything will work. I'm using 4, so life is good. So that's the one dependency I need on the Servlet and JSP API. The other thing I need to set, notice here, I've got the Maven war plugin and I'm telling it to not bother me about that web.xml file, fail on missing web.xml, false. So that should get rid of my error. And I'm also using the Maven compiler plugin to force JDK and Java 1.8 compliance. So that is the Maven POM file. Feel free to use Gradle. Feel free to just drop different files into the folder there. I'm going to go Maven update project, but Maven tends to be a pretty good way to manage your dependencies. Okay, now that's just the basic configuration. I want to do a file upload, and if I want to do a file upload, I need a file uploader. That means creating an HTML file, which I'm going to call uploader.html. And in this HTML file, along with all the basic HTML that Eclipse will give me, Java Ajax servlet file upload, just put a title in there if you want. What really matters is what goes in here, and what goes in here is my form element that includes a file selector. So I'm going to start off by putting a form element in here. Method is post. It's going to call a servlet I will create in a moment called the file upload servlet, and the encoding type is going to be multi-part. Basically, when the browser sends data to the server, it chunks it. It doesn't send a great big 10 gig file. It sends it, you know, 1 meg at a time or whatever. It sends it in parts. And so the file upload type is multi-part. And when we configure our servlet, we're going to have to make sure that it supports that with an annotation. But that's important. I'm going to end my form there. Now, when you create an HTML form with HTML5, you can use the HTML5 type file element. Notice this, type equals file. That's new. Before, you only had submit, or you only had input or text area. So we can actually have a file input. When this runs, this will actually display a selector field where somebody can click on a button and browse their local file system for a file. So that's new. That's our HTML5 element. We also need a submit button to send this to the server. And so this is the client part of the application. Now, if you really want to be tricky, and I don't know if I like hanging around people that are tricky, but one of the things you can do is you can actually do an Ajax call. So you can add in, let me see if I can do this here. How do I do this? You can add in, you don't have to use a form, you can just add in an input field and a button. And the input field, again, file type, so that's going to be the selector. And we can have a button that calls on a JavaScript method, and we can have this uploaded through JavaScript. The JavaScript, if you're a Ajax JavaScript person, I was born in Ajax, Ontario, so I guess I'm an Ajax person. The script isn't too difficult. The script isn't too difficult, but I did paste it in incorrectly there, so it would help if I did it properly. Okay, here's the script. It's right there. Okay, here's what the script does. The script runs when somebody clicks on this button, upload file, calls the upload file method. This method creates a form data object, which it's going to use to send data to the server. What it wants to send to the server is this file here, right? It's got the ID of Ajax file, so we can say, get the file associated with that Ajax file, name it file, and put it into the form. That's the file name, that's the name file there that's going to go in the request response parameter headers. So we put that, send that up to the server with the name file. We call the file upload servlet with a post, including that form data, and then hopefully everything goes well on the server. When the server says, yeah, that all works, we get an alert on the client. So the cool thing about this is going to upload the files using Ajax. You won't leave the page, whereas with the form you will. Anyways, a little razzle dazzle there, just giving you an idea of how you can actually implement that both using a standard static form and also using some super cool Ajax. Now, none of this is going to work unless you've got a component on the server which captures this incoming request. If you think putting together a little form is all you need in order to get a file uploader working, you've got another thing coming. I've got to come over to the server here, and I got to create a new servlet. This servlet is going to be the com.mcnc.web package, and it's going to be called the file upload servlet. I'll click next there. I don't want like that mapping. I think all servlet should be file upload servlet. I think all servlets and web resources should be all lowercase letters. So I'm changing that there. I don't want any of this stuff. And just click finish. And that gives me my nice little class right there. File upload extends HTTP servlet. I'm actually going to update that web servlet mapping there. Probably don't need to, but I'm going to change this. I'm just going to add a name and URL pattern there. I think that just looks a little bit more explicit, although I don't think I needed to do that. But what I do need to do is I need to add this annotation here. And notice as soon as I add this annotation, it's going to clap back at me right there. That's only because I need to organize my imports so that the code can actually find that class as it's imported. There you'll see imported multi-part config. But what this does is it makes it possible for this servlet to be able to handle file uploads in chunked format. So that upload.html file, it sent data in multi-parts. Here we are going to do a multi-part config annotation to allow support for that. Okay, and this file uploader, it used the post invocation, so did Ajax. It used post as well. That means over on the server, I have to implement a do post method. So I'm going to put that in there. That's just your standard do post method. Nothing crazy or interesting about that. Again, I have to organize my imports because I can't find the servlet request and servlet response object, but no problem. Now, what do I actually do in this code? Well, we're going to have all sorts of parts of files coming to the server. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually just going to get one of those parts. I can say, hey, just give me one of those parts. And from the parts that are coming to the server, I want the name of the file that was uploaded. I'm going to use the name of the file as it was uploaded as the name of the file that I save on the file system. I mean, I could, you know, every time a file comes in, I could call it abc123.jpg or something. But it makes sense if somebody uploads a file named caliselfie.jpg, I save it locally as caliselfie.jpg. That will give me the file name. Now, by the way, I believe this won't work on 3.0. This definitely won't work on 2.5. None of this will work in 2.5, but 3.0, you have to take a different strategy for getting the file name, so you are forewarned. Looks like I need to do an organize imports once again. And there we go, the little error message on file part went away. Okay, so now what do I want to do? Well, I want to save all of that file, all of the chunks, into my upload folder. And so I'm going to loop through all of the different chunks that are sent up here. So get all the parts from the request object. And one part at a time, what I want to do is I want to write that data into a file in C upload. Right now, there's nothing in that C upload folder. You can see that right there, nothing in it. And the file that I want to write to is basically the file that's got the same name as the file that was uploaded. So I take the file name of the upload and I create a file in this folder, and then I write all of the pieces to it, essentially taking the file that was uploaded and saving it to the local machine. Now, finally, this is a servlet, so I can forward to a JSP. I'm just going to write something out and say, hey, the file was uploaded successfully. Way to go. You know, I mean, this isn't... you know, great MVC, and maybe it's not going to be win me any awards for UI development, but it's going to work, and working is good. I'll allow you to deal with the corner cases and fixing and writing any unit tests on your own. I just want to get this to work. But that's it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 lines of code. How could life get any easier? That's all you have to do with Servlet 3.1 to handle the file upload and save that file locally. Now, I'm just going to look at my code. Did I do everything right here? There's the input buttons. There's the form. File upload servlet. Okay, this all looks good. The Ajax call with the post. Okay, well, I am going to deploy this. I'm going to take a look at that uploader.html, right click, say run as run on server. We need a Tomcat 9 server in order to run this, but I will run it and I will click finish. I'm actually going to take that URL right there and I'm actually going to just paste it into Chrome. So there's Chrome right there running that program. So that looks good. And I'm also going to bring the upload folder over here as well. As you can see, there's nothing currently in it. And then I'm going to choose a file. So there's Callie looking happy, nice smile. So always taking selfies. So I got the Callie selfie. I'll upload it. And bang, there we go. That file is uploaded to that folder. Now, that was a full request response cycle, change the page. But if I come over here and do Ajax, I can choose a file, and there's a nice little picture of my book. I can open that file up, click upload here. It says the file was uploaded with Ajax and Java successfully, and now that Pickering Springfield book is right there. And so now I've got this working both with a standard form and with Ajax. And there you go. That's all there is to putting together a Java-based file upload with Servlet and JSP API 3.1 using HTML form and input elements and making it all standard, static, or even asynchronous and Ajax-based. And there you go. That's how easy it is to put together a Java servlet and JSP API file uploader that not only uploads with a basic HTML5 form, but also uses Ajax and JavaScript to get the job done. Pretty awesome. Only takes about 5 lines of code in your Java. It's amazing how far we've progressed in the world of enterprise software development with Java and Java EE, and I guess I should say Jakarta EE as well. Now, if you enjoyed that tutorial, why don't you head over to theserverside.com? We've got lots of great tutorials about enterprise software development and Java in general over there. If you're interested in my antics, you can follow me on Twitter at CameronMCNZ and subscribe on YouTube.